Introduction to the Delta-wye transformer connection, part 7D. In this part, we're going to continue our discussion about how this transformer connection name is designated by these two methods. In part 7C, we talked about some of these problems that come up with this designation here, the 11. The 11 is a source of our confusions. Okay, but some of the rules of thumbs that I have come to learn will help clear up this confusion. Okay, so the rule of thumbs. The first rule is when we're comparing the high voltage winding with the low voltage winding, right? So we're comparing this high voltage winding with this low voltage winding. We always compare the high voltage reference quantity, and I'm going to explain this term in just a little while, quantity with the low voltage reference. So we always compare the high voltage reference quantity with the low voltage reference quantity when determining the phase shift. So let me make that a little bit smaller. Okay, so the second rule of thumb is that, so in terms of how standard transformer name designations, we start at the high voltage quantity and rotate clockwise direction until we reach the low voltage reference quantity. Okay, so let me repeat this again. In terms of how transformer naming designations are defined, we're talking about like how this Dyn11 designation, we start at the high voltage quantity and rotate in the clockwise direction. Okay, so this is a key word. We rotate in this clockwise direction until we reach the low voltage reference quantity. So what we're saying is that once we have this high voltage reference quantity for winding A, okay, we rotate in the clockwise direction until we get to the low voltage reference quantity for winding A on the secondary side. So we rotate in the clockwise direction. So this is 330 degrees, like in our example. So in this type of a designation, we're rotating in the clockwise direction. I hope that makes sense. So now I'm going to make this a little bit smaller. So in general terms, this reference quantity is always defined as a line to ground quantity or a line to neutral quantity, okay? So on the high voltage side, VAG, VBG, and VCG are our reference quantities, okay, on the high voltage side, which is the delta side. So when we're comparing two values, we have to compare apples to apples. So we use, for the sake of simplicity, we use VAG. So VAG is our reference quantity on the high voltage side, okay? Now the reference quantity on our low voltage side, which is connected in Y, is VAG. Again, right? The voltage across line A and ground, okay? So VAG is our reference quantity on the low voltage side. So when we're comparing the high voltage winding and the low voltage winding to determine the phase shift, we have to compare VAG on the high voltage side versus the VAG on the low voltage side. Does that make sense? Now, granted, there are other quantities that we can compare, but for the sake of simplicity and our rule of thumbs, we're only going to compare to line to ground quantities, okay? Now, what does that look like in our phasor diagram? So what we're saying in our phasor diagram is that this VAG, which is this high voltage reference quantity, we're comparing VAG with VAG on the low voltage side. See that? So we're comparing this high voltage reference quantity with this low voltage reference quantity to determine the phase shift. For this transformer connection, it's pretty obvious that the phase shift between the high voltage side and the low voltage side is 30 degrees, right? But the question is, how does this transformer designation actually work with respect to our phasor diagram? And that is what we're gonna cover in part 7E. So in this video tutorial, we looked at these two rule of thumbs, right? The first rule of thumb is that we're comparing the high voltage and the low voltage reference quantity. And the other rule of thumb is that when we are comparing it, we have to start at the high voltage quantity and then rotate in the clockwise direction until we reach the low voltage reference quantity. So this right here, this is implying that we have a 330 degrees phase shift, right? Now, if you find this confusing, don't worry. I was very confused at first as well, but there's a very easy way to digest this information, and that comes through the method of the clock system. And just to give you a quick peek of this clock system is that you draw a clock and then you have hours on a clock, right? You have 6 and then you have 9, 7 here, 8 and 11. And the hour hand obviously always moves in the clockwise direction. We're going to look at how we can define this phasor diagram with this clock system and make sense out of this intuitively. Now, if you haven't subscribed already, please click on this button here. Just click on this here and you'll get subscribed to this channel and keep up to date. And if you're like me who always questions and comments things, go ahead and leave your questions or comments below. This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power system protection, automation, and controls intuitive.